Welcome to the first instructional film of the German and international World of Tanks clan, Panzerknacker. My name is Grimblut and I'd like to tell you some basic information about how the detection system of World of Tanks works. We will start with direct detection. Imagine this is your tank. You have spawned in a battle. You take a look around yourself and see a house at a far distance. After a few moments have passed, an enemy tank suddenly pops up between you and the house. Now how can that be? How could you have seen the house but not the enemy tank right in front of it? You see, World of Tanks uses two different systems which decide whether you see objects or do not see them in game. The first system is called draw distance. This draw distance is responsible for every object in the game like trees, stones, houses and so on. Every object except enemy tanks. The only thing which limits the draw distance is the corresponding option in the game settings. If you set the draw distance setting to high, the maximum setting, you will see objects at an in-game distance of about 700 meters. As I have mentioned before, a different system is responsible for the detection of enemy tanks. This system is called the view range. The view range is exclusively responsible for the detection of enemy tanks. The view range is much shorter than the draw distance range. It is kept for all tanks at 500 meters. The view range for most tanks is much lower though, as there are several other limiting factors. Every tank has its own view range maximum. You can see that maximum in the details of a tank if you look at it in the tech tree or, if you own it, in your garage. The M3 Stuart, for example, has a view range of 380 meters. This value is the maximum possible view range of this tank. This is a major source of misunderstanding. The M3 Stuart doesn't have a view range of 380 meters, but this range is the maximum possible view range you can achieve with this tank. You only get this maximum view range if your commander has a crew level of 100%. And if your tank is equipped with a binocular, and if your tank doesn't move for 3 seconds so that the binocular gets actually activated. If your commander only got a crew skill of 50%, then the effective view range of your tank is halved. If you drive around with a low-skilled commander and without a binocular or coated optics, you have to realize that your effective view range is only a fraction of the value given in your tank's details. Now we'll talk about indirect detection. Imagine you're playing together with a friend. Your tank is number 1 and his the number 2. Every tank has a signal range which depends on the tank's radio. The signal range can vary between only a few hundred meters and up to over 800 meters. An enemy tank enters your friend's view range and gets detected. The enemy tank is obviously out of your view range. But since you and your ally are within signal range, the enemies your friend detects are also visible to you. As long as the distance between you and your ally is less than the sum of both your signal ranges, you will see every tank he detects on the minimap. If the enemy tank is within your draw distance, you can even see this enemy on the field. Your view range doesn't matter in this case, only your draw distance. As long as you do not move into the enemy's view range, he won't be able to detect you. You can fire on him without having any fear to get detected by him. Imagine your friend would not fire at the enemy tank, but hide behind a bush or so. The result may be that the enemy tank sees neither you nor your friend. While your friend must not shoot to stay hidden, you and your team's artillery can safely fire at the enemy tank. Many people who complain about so-called ghost tanks or invisible tanks do just not understand this very important, very tactical aspect of the game. Another very important and underestimated fact is that the player who's the first to detect an enemy tank gets 50% of the experience and cash for the damage that other players inflict upon this enemy. Let me show you what this means. Look at the score. I did not fire one single shot during this battle and still made over 1,600 XP and 77,000 cash. This is the reward you can get as a good scout. I hope I was able to get one or two things across to you. If you ask yourself how the detection system works in conjunction with the camouflage skill, the camouflage net, or hiding behind objects, then take a look at the second Panzerknacker instructional film. Thank you for your time and your interest. See you on the field.